What's going on, my fellow Kino Lord? So I just got out of a screening for Sasquatch Sunset. Now, Sasquatch Sunset is written and directed by David and Nathan Zellner. And basically, this is an R-rated depiction of a Sasquatch family in the wilderness. Nothing more, nothing less. That's what this movie is. And I've never seen a Zellner film before. I've heard of a handful of them, like Kumiko the Treasure Hunter. That's one I've been wanting to see for a while. But I've never seen any of their films, so I didn't know exactly what to expect. But let me just tell you, I came out of this movie really, really enjoying it. I don't know, this was just a funny, entertaining, and in some ways, like, it had a lot of heart and felt very human, and it was just an interesting experience. It was an interesting and different kind of cinematic experience. Now, that being said, this shit ain't gonna be for everybody. It's just, again, it gets pretty absurd. It gets very unhinged. In a lot of ways, just very raw and graphic depiction of, you know, what it would be like if we followed an actual Sasquatch family in the wilderness. And personally, I liked that about it. I really did, because it's, yes, in one way it's absurd and it's kind of outrageous and ridiculous, but in another way, it does feel like, I don't know, like, natural, and there's a primal thing about it that feels oddly believable, and it's also very comedic. Like, this is a really funny movie. I found it quite hilarious. There's so many scenes in this movie where I was just dying with laughter and thought it was just really great comedic writing and performances. Honestly, like, that's just the way that that was my experience watching this movie. And it's another thing about it is that it's completely dialogue-less. No dialogue throughout this entire film. I thought maybe at one point there would be some kind of random human character coming into the mix, like maybe like looking at the Sasquatches for a second and saying some words or something. But I mean, there's no human characters in this movie. It's just the Sasquatches. Not to say that humanity doesn't come into play in this film in some way. And also not to say that the Sasquatches don't come into contact with humanity in some way. But this is just the Sasquatches. No dialogue. Everything is expressed through physicality and direction and performances, and it's all expressed through, again, nothing but the direction of the film and the writing that went into the script. And as I mentioned, this is a film that I could see people walking out of this movie. Like, there was two other people in the film, and I thought maybe they might walk out, because they were on the older side. Because it is just so, like, there's parts that are just barbaric, and, you know, a lot of people find this really gross and disgusting. The depiction of, like, primal sexuality in this film, and again, just the kind of, like, unhinged animalistic nature of it. It's just all here. Like, it just does not hold back at all. It just goes for it and is completely unafraid to just explore all these avenues. But it's mostly in a way that you can't help but laugh at as well. I mean, some of it, yeah, it's like gross as shit, and it's like kind of, you know, it can be hard to watch. But for the most part, like, it is funny at the same time. And yeah, like, I think this is a really, like, when I was watching this movie, it definitely hit a point to where I was thinking, like, what is this movie trying to say? What are its themes, and what's the point of it all? And essentially, I think they wanted to explore this concept mostly because Sasquatches are such an interesting, like, in-between position of ape and human, to where they can explore their characters in terms of their behavior in a way that comes off relatable to us as humans, but then in a way comes off very, again, like ape-like and savage. But also, even the ape-like savage stuff, we can relate to on a certain level. Obviously, it's more dramatic and outrageous because of how animalistic it is, but we're animals too, and we're not so far removed from that kind of behavior. We're just more civilized. More civilized about it, more delicate about the way we behave. But in terms of the urges and overall behavior and the way we react to things, it's hard not to apply what's going on here to yourself. Obviously, maybe some people will watch it and not feel that, and that's why they might walk out and be like, this is just fucking disgusting and vile, and, you know, just have no ability to relate to what's happening. But that's just not the way I felt. And I think that's what the Zellner brothers were kind of going for with this movie, is they wanted to create this really weird, primal yet human experience that can kind of get humans to, I don't know, relate to animals and even their ancestors on a more intimate level, while also being able to just deliver something that is really entertaining and comedic. And yeah, and again, it's actually, like, it has a lot of heart in it as well. It's mostly comedic, but there is a decent, like, core to this movie that feels spiritual in a way. Especially, like, with some uses of the cinematography and the score. There's a lot of, like, horned instrument sounds to the score that sounds very, like, bendy and kind of weird and trippy. And I think it adds a really interesting vibe and atmosphere to it all. But, yeah, and there are some parts in this film that made me feel emotional. You know, especially with something that happens, like, somewhere in the second act of the film, where it's just like, it kind of hit me right in the feels. And there's also some, like, environmental themes as well. It's not, you know, it's not so preachy about it. It's just kind of there, but it is there in this movie, and I thought that was an interesting incorporation as well. And one thing that I was also thinking about watching this movie was that, in one way, this had to be an absolute blast for the cast to make. But the two stars in the film are Riley Keough, which is awesome, and Jesse Eisenberg. And I just thought to myself, this must have been a blast to make, but at the same time, could have been an absolutely grueling experience, because of just all the makeup and all the prosthetic work and the suit and everything that had to be put on every single day on set. Apparently there was like 2 hours worth of makeup, you know, just for every day on set. And that's just the makeup. And it's just like, I couldn't imagine, like, every single day having to go through all this, putting on this freaking suit, going through all that makeup, and, you know, acting your heart out. But in one way, like, it must have been grueling because of that. But another way, it looked like it would have been so much fun to give such a unique performance, which a lot of actors have never really done a performance like that. It's a kind of a rare opportunity to do something like this. But I loved the pretty much pure reliance on makeup work and practical effects. Like, I couldn't spot any CGI in this movie. If there was CGI, it maybe was like a backdrop or some kind of like smoke in the distance or something like that. But like all the up close stuff that you see, all that shit to me looked just like pure practical effects work. And there's, I mean, there's even a scene with like a baby Sasquatch that is like, in one way it's kind of, I see somebody being like, oh, come on, that's really dumb looking. But for me, again, I just thought it added to this really oddly, it's like this surreal but oddly natural feel to the movie. And the prosthetic work and what seemed to me to be like animatronic work or something on the baby is just like, I just really commend that. I just really like, you know, in spots where they could have used CGI and in terms of like having a film that relied on CGI, like they just really didn't. It was just purely just going all in on prosthetic and practical effects. And I admired that a lot. I admired that a lot from this film. But yeah, I mean, in terms of criticisms, all I can really say is that I kind of wanted more out of it. I think thematically and narratively, it could have offered a bit more. It gets to a point where I feel like it doesn't really know what else more to do than what it already did. And it feels like it kind of just has to end. And it's not that I dislike the ending. I think the ending's okay. But I felt like it could have had a more profound ending. Could have had a little bit more thematically substantive elements to explore throughout the film. But in a way, it does come off more as a comedy. And it offered so much of that, in my opinion. And it was really, really entertaining. And so, yeah, like, really the biggest criticism is that I just wanted more. I thought it could have been more, but it kind of stops where, at what it wants to do, and it stops where it ends, and that's just what it is. But overall, yeah, like, I still very much enjoyed this film. And I personally recommend it. Again, I don't know if it's not going to be everybody's cup of tea, that's for sure. But I definitely recommend it. Just prepare yourself for what you're getting into. It's a very primal and bodily movie. Very, again, unhinged with its raw depictions of, like, just barbarism and savagery. Just very, it's a very animalistic movie, but at the same time, a very human movie. And I think that's kind of what makes it really special. So with that being said, I will give it a solid to strong 7 out of 10. Maybe on rewatch, I'll give it a higher rating, because I'm definitely going to be watching this movie again at some point. Just a really unique experience. And I definitely want people to go out and support this. This is like one of those, I'm sure this is like what people on the outside view. That's like, oh, this is like one of those weird, indie movies. And this is like probably the reason why people on the outside don't want to watch weird indie movies, because of movies like this. But I love this kind of shit. Like, I don't know. I just love, because it's just, it's different. And it feels like such a creative and personal type of movie. That wasn't made out of pressures to make money or anything. It was just made out of somebody's brain. And you could tell that it's just somebody had a passion and wanted to make it. And that's why it's here. But anyway, I think that's all I got to say on Sasquatch Sunset, guys. If you really enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it amongst your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to be updated on more from related content.